वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू इन एस एस टी कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड कॉमर्स। दिस इज एस एस टी एजुपेडिया। आई एम मिस्टर सुधाकर पाटिल, लेक्चरर फ्रॉम एस एस टी कॉलेज ऑफ आर्ट्स एंड कॉमर्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द पोयम द सोअर, विच इज रिटन बाय विक्टर ह्यूगो। इट इज ट्रांसलेटेड बाय तोरुलत्ता दत्त इन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज, in which we learn that how the farmer is working in his farm till evening. Poet Victor Hugo described the life of hard working person. That person is a farmer. This poem is dedicated to the farmer of the France, but basically I think this poem is about the farmers of all over the world. So let us see, today we are going to learn poetic devices and poetic appreciation from this poem. As per the stanza wise, in the first stanza, poet uses a different kinds of poetic devices like a personification. In line number second, sunlight I see dying fast. This is the example of personification, because poet uses the human quality of dying given to the sunlight. Here the quality of dying is given to the sunlight. So this is the example of personification. In line number second, sound S is repeated. Sunlight I see dying fast. In the word sunlight, S sound is there. In the words see, S sound is there. So in this sentence, S sound is repeated two times. So this is the example of alliteration. In line number three, again poet uses the personification. Twilight hastens on to rule. It is an example of personification because hastening is the human quality. It is given to the non-human object twilight there. The poet uses the quality of hastening to the twilight. So this is the example of personification. In line number fourth, working hours have well nigh passed. Poet uses alliteration because in this sentence, W sound or W consonant is repeated two times in the word working and in the word well. So these are the figure of speeches used by poet in the first stanza. Let us see in the next stanza. In next stanza, in line number first, shadows run across the land. Poet uses human quality of running is given to the shadows. Here poet applies the quality of running, the human quality, to the shadows. So this is the example of personification. In line number first and second, there is a use of the figure of speech antithesis. If there is a use of words of, if in a same sentence there is a use of the opposite words are there, there is an example of antithesis. Shadows run across the lands, but a sower lingers still. In this sentence, run and still, both words are opposite to each other. So this is the example of antithesis. Next one, in line number second, but a sower lingers still. Poet uses alliteration here. There is a repetition of the S sound two times in the word sower also, in the word still also. In line number third, old in rags he patient stands. Poet uses inversion here. The order of the words are changed for poetic effect. In the basically when the poets write the poem there, the poet uses the different kinds of structure or maybe different kind of sentence structure there. The poet maybe changes the order of the sentence there. The correct order is there. He stands patient in old rags. So this is the example of inversion. In next stanza, In line number first, second, third, and fourth, poet uses the figure of speech alliteration. In the first line, H sound is repeated two times in the word high and his. In the second line, D sound is repeated two times, dominates and dips. So this is also example of alliteration. In the third line, S sound is repeated two times, so and set. So there is example, this is example of alliteration. In the last line or in the fourth line, S sound is repeated two times. So these are the examples of alliteration. In line number third and fourth, poet uses the inversion. The order of the words are changed for poetic effect. The correct order is there. Now the task is said to sow. A time shall come soon to reap. This is the correct order as per the sentence structure. Let us see next stanza. In line number third and fourth, from his hands the precious grain, I muse, as I see him stride. In the line number third, poet repeats H sound two times in the word H, his, or in the word hands. In the fourth line, poet repeats S sound two times in the word see and in the word stride. So both are the examples of alliteration. Along with them, poet also uses the repetition here in the line number second and line number fourth. To and fro and scatters wide. In this sentence, in the line number second, the word and is repeated two times. So this is the example of repetition. In the line number fourth, muse I as I see him stride. In this last line, poet repeats I, this alphabet, two times. So this is the example of repetition. Line number first, second, third, and fourth, poet changes the order of the sentence there for poetic effect. So these are the examples of, we can say, inversion. The correct order is there. He marches to and fro along the plain and scatters wide the precious grain from his hands. In next stanza, in line number first, third, and fourth, poet uses the alliteration here. In the line number one, D sound repeats two times in the word darkness and deepens. In the line number third, H sound repeat two times in the word H and height. In the line number fourth, S sound repeat two times in the word S and starry. In the word seems and starry. So these are the examples of alliteration. Along with them, in line number second and third, poet uses the example of inversion. The order of the words are changed from poetic effect. The correct order is there. Now his gestures are angust to mine eyes. Students, in this way, a poet uses a different types of figure of speech like alliterations, inversion, personification. Let us see about the poetic appreciation from this poem. When we want to write that question there, when we want to learn about the poetic appreciation, there are some points are there, like about the poem, poet or title. The poem, The Sower, is a description of a lone farmer toiling in his field. There is one lonely one, lone farmer is there. The time is evening. As the poet watches even after sundown, Toru Dutta, in her translation of Victor Hugo's poem, speaks in a praise of his dedication. Now this how the farmer dedicates his hard work in his farming. This true reality is given by Victor Hugo, and that reality translated by poetess Toru Dutt. The theme of the poem. The poem is woven around the theme of farmer surveying his land, taking upon himself the hard work to till it, and plodding on into the night. Even after day is done, he seeks neither help nor company, but does what needs doing. The farmer is lonely working in his farming till night. So this show the hard working or hard works of farmer. Poetic devices, language and style. As we learn poetic devices, the poet has used devices like alliteration, imagery and symbolism to create the scene in the reader's mind. The rhyming scheme is A-B-A-B, providing a pleasing rhythm to read aloud. The language comprises words used in a manner to create a commanding figure of the farmer in order to emphasize the importance of his occupation and the toil it entails. Black high, his silhouette dominates, symbolizing a huge figure, and against the sky marches he along. I see him stride, a confident figure in charge. His height seems to touch the starry skies, a figure to respect. The poet herself is in awe and sets the to nigh the reader's mind to look at the farmer with the respect or reverence which we must give him. So in this poem, the poet tries to give the respect to that farmer. Or the farmer is one of the a hard worker person who always remains positive in his life. Apart from many difficulties in his life, a person who devotes, who sacrifices his life for the welfare of country or for the welfare of humankind. Special features, novelties, focusing elements. There is emphasis on two aspects. Number one is there hard work with the farmer performance uncomplainingly day and night. Some examples are a sower lingers to sow, the task marches he. So in the first one example, the farmer doing any complain till night, he is working in farming. This is the first picture is there. He is sowing something, doing the task of sowing in the farming. The other aspect is the vivid description of the ducks, the sitting sun and the figure against the sunset. The sunlight I see dying fast, twilight, darkness deepens, his silhouette dominates. There is a use of poetic language adding to the novelty and beauty. This is not the ordinary language. Well nigh mine eyes, he patient stands, muse I. In several lines, the words are in different order from what is used normally. Furrows dips, marches he along, fades the light. So in this way, poet changes the structure of, we can say, structure of sentence for the poetic effects. The poet uses the figure of speech inversion here. The inversion as the poetic device adds effect. Values or message. What a message do we get from this poem? The poem gives a very important message. It brings into focus the importance of farmer and his unrecognized service to the society. However much money one may possess, one cannot eat the money. One needs the farmer for one's very survival. So in this message, we can get the message of, we can say, sacrifice, the message of hard working, of the farmer till night working in his farm for to produce something grains. That farmer help us, that farmer can fulfill our also food also there. Your opinion about the poem. The poem is effective in creating a positive, respectful picture of the farmer. His simple life and stoicism is seen in the way the poet describes his action. So I think this is the poem. Through this poem, poet is tries to give the respect to the farmer. The poet shows the reality of farmer, how the farmer sacrificed hard work in his farming to produce some grain in his farm there. How is, I think, production helps to the persons, or we can say the, to the nation. Writing this poem, the poet is trying to give the respect to that farmer there. Basically, Victor Hugo has written this poem for the farmer of France. But when the poetess Turgot translated this poem from French language into English language there, so this poem is dedicated for the all over the farmers of the world. So students, in this way, we learn poetic devices and poetic appreciation from this poem. I think we have to give the respect to the, all the farmers, because farmer is the backbone of our society. Thank you to all of you.